Amen. I want to speak to you for the next 20 minutes on what I've captioned anointing and favor. Somebody say anointing and favor. Say it loud and clear. Say anointing and favor. In 1 Samuel chapter 10 verse 1 through 10, the Bible said, then Samuel took a veil of oil and poured it upon his head and kissed him and said, is it not because the Lord has anointed thee to be captain over his inheritance? Put a scripture on the screen. 1 Samuel chapter 10 verse 1. When thou art departed from me today, then thou shalt find two men by Rachel's sepulcher in the border of Benjamin at Zilzah. And they will say unto thee, the asses which thou wentest to seek are found. And lo, thy father has left the care of the asses and sorrowed for you, saying, what shall I do for my son? Verse 3. Then shalt thou go forward. Somebody say forward. Say loud and clear. Say forward. Then shalt thou go on forward from thence, and thou shalt come to the plain of Tabor, and thou shalt meet three men going up to go to Bethel, one carrying three kids, and another carrying three loaves of bread, and another carrying a bottle of wine. And they will salute thee and give thee two loaves of bread, which thou shalt receive of their hands. Say a big amen. Tonight, what I want to reveal to us is the relationship between the anointing and favor. There is a direct connection between the anointing and favor. Anytime you want to walk in favor, you must be connected to the oil. Anytime you want to walk in breakthrough, you must be connected to the oil. Anytime you want to walk in miracles and elevation, you must be connected to the oil, because there is a direct relationship between the anointing and favor. Somebody say the anointing and favor. Tap a brother or a sister. Say, brother, instead of you to pray for favor, cry for the anointing. Do things that will attract the anointing. Somebody said the anointing. Now, I'm going to look at four case study. Number one, the example of Saul. Somebody says Saul. The Bible said when Saul was anointed, favor answered. In 1 Samuel chapter 10 verse 3 to 4. Then shalt thou go on forward from thence, and thou shalt come to the plain of Tabor, and there shall meet three men going up to God, to Bethel, one carrying three kids, and another carrying three loaves of bread, and another carrying a bottle of wine. And they will salute thee and give thee two loaves of bread, which thou shalt receive from their hands. But remember, in verse 1, the Bible said the oil came upon Saul. And when the oil came upon Saul, look at verse 4. The Bible said, and they will salute thee and give thee two loaves of bread, which thou shalt receive from their hands. So anytime you are anointed, or anytime the anointing comes upon you, or anytime you connect to the oil, what you attract is the favor of God. Saul was anointed and people started saluting him. Saul was anointed and the asses of his father that was lost was found. There is somebody seated here tonight. I declare that between now and December 31st, the anointing is coming upon you. And as the anointing rests upon you, you will attract the favor of God. Lift up your right and say, Father, anoint me with fresh oil. Lift your hands and say, Father, anoint me afresh. When the oil comes upon you, you experience restoration. When the oil comes upon you, you experience resurrection. When the oil comes upon you, you experience recovery. And tonight, I see God restoring you whatever you have lost. I see every death thing in your life coming alive. And I see recovery coming for you. Say a big amen. Number two, the example of David. In 1 Samuel chapter 16 verse 13, the Bible said, then Samuel took the horn of oil and anointed him in the midst of his brethren. And the Spirit of the Lord came upon him. And the Bible said David went forward. So Samuel rose up and went to Ramah. Jump to verse 18. Look at what happened when the anointing came upon David. Verse 18. Then answered one of the servants and said, behold, I've seen a son of Jesse, the Bethlehemite that is cunning in plain, and a mighty valiant man, and a man of war, a prudent of prudent matters, and a comely person, and the Lord was with him. Jump to verse 21. And David came to Saul and stood before him, and he loved him greatly, and he became his armor bearer. There is somebody here tonight. God's anointing is coming upon you. The Holy Ghost is coming upon you. God's Spirit is coming upon you. And after today, places that you go, that the doors shut, you will go and the doors will open unto you effortlessly. After today, people will look at you and they will recognize you, that the oil is upon you. People will look at you and they will see uniqueness on your life. People will look at you and they will see an anointing upon you. There is somebody here after tonight. I prophesy, doors that were shut for you, it will open unto you effortlessly because of the anointing. Lift up your right and say, Father, anoint me with fresh oil. When the oil comes upon you, you don't struggle for favor. When the oil comes upon you, you don't struggle for recognition. When the oil comes upon you, you walk in favor effortlessly. You walk in breakthrough effortlessly. You walk in success effortlessly. And I see the oil coming upon you. Watch this. The Bible said, immediately David stood before Saul. Saul loved David, and David became the armor bearer of Saul. There is somebody seated here. You have been going to places and they've been rejecting you, but after today you will go and they will accept you. After today you will go and they will welcome you. Lift up your right and say, Father, let your oil come upon me. Say, Father, let the anointing rest upon me. Watch this. Whatever you have to do to attract the oil, go ahead and do it. Whatever you have to do to walk in the anointing, go ahead and do it. Because there is a direct relationship between the anointing and favor. Instead of you to be praying for favor, crying for favor, rather do things that will cause you to remain anointed, to walk in the anointing. And once the oil is upon you, favor is automatic. Tap a brother. Say, brother, once the oil is on you, once you carry grace, favor is automatic. There is a beautiful lady here tonight. I see the oil coming upon you. I see marital door about to open. There is a handsome young man here tonight. I see the oil coming upon you. I thought your amen would be the loudest. Lift up your right and say, Father, let the oil rest upon me. And watch this. I'm not talking about physical olive oil coming upon you. I'm talking about the Holy Spirit possessing you. I'm talking about the Holy Spirit taking over your life. I'm talking about the Holy Spirit taking over your family. And tonight I see the Holy Spirit coming on you. When praises goes high, blessings come down. Who am I speaking to? Receive the anointing right now. Say, I am anointed. I'm not hearing you. Say, I'm anointed. Number three, our Master Jesus Christ. Third example, our Master Jesus Christ. In Luke chapter 3, verse 21 through 22. Now when all the people were baptized, it came to pass that Jesus also being baptized and praying, the heaven was open. Somebody said the heaven was open. And the Holy Spirit descended in a bodily shape like a dove upon him. And a voice came from heaven which said, Thou art my beloved son, in thee I am well pleased. That is the anointing. That dove that descended upon the Holy, upon Jesus, that is the anointing. Somebody say the anointing. Now look at the outcome of the anointing in Luke chapter 4 verse 14. And Jesus returned in the power of the Spirit into Galilee. After tonight, you are returning in the Spirit, in the power, into wherever you came from. And the Bible said, give me verse 14 quickly. And the Bible said, and there went out a fame of him through the region round about. Tap a brother, say brother. You don't need any complimentary card. You don't need anybody's complimentary card. You don't need any connection. Once the oil comes on you, the oil will announce you. The oil will advertise you. The oil will publicize you. Can I prophesy? The Holy Ghost is about to advertise your ministry. The Holy Ghost is about to advertise your preach. I'm not hearing you. The Holy Ghost is about to advertise your breakthrough. Tap a brother. Say, brother, all that you need is the anointing. When the oil came upon Jesus, the Bible said his fame spread abroad. Everybody heard of Jesus. People will hear of you. I said people will hear of you. I said people will hear of you. Can I prophesy? Your business is about to go global. Your business is about to go international. Your business is about to cross the boundaries of America because of the anointing. Somebody said the anointing. When you carry oil, you don't talk too much. When you carry oil, you don't explain yourself. When you carry oil, you don't calculate things. The oil speaks for you. And tonight, I see somebody coming under the anointing. Who am I speaking to? Receive the anointing. May the Holy Ghost possess you. May the Holy Ghost come upon you. Lift up your right and say, Father, anoint me afresh in the name of Jesus. Number four, the example of the apostles. Somebody say the apostles. In Acts chapter 2 verse 1 to 6. And when the day of Pentecost was fully come, they were all with one accord in one place. And suddenly there came a sound from heaven as of a rushing mighty wind. And it filled all the house where they were sitting. Verse 3. And there appeared unto them cloven tongues like as of fire. And it sat upon them, each of them. I love verse 4. And they were all filled with the Holy Ghost. As we have gathered here tonight, I see the Holy Ghost filling us. I see the Holy Spirit empowering us. I see the oil coming upon us. They were filled with the Holy Ghost and began to speak with other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. Look at verse 5. And there were dwelling at Jerusalem Jews, devout men, out of every nation under heaven. Now when this was noised abroad, somebody say, when this was noised abroad. Now watch this. In those days, we had no Facebook, we had no Instagram, we had no newspaper, we had no CNN. But the Bible said it was noised abroad. When the Holy Ghost comes upon you, when the anointing comes upon you, the anointing begins to advertise you. People begin to look for you. People begin to gather around you. You begin to attract prominent people, men of timber and of caliber. Can I prophesy? May the oil rest upon you tonight. But I'm not hearing your amen. May the oil rest upon you tonight. Let your amen be the loudest. May the oil rest upon you. The Bible said it was noised abroad. The multitude came together and they were confounded because that every man heard them speak of his own language. Somebody said the anointing. I'm not hearing your voice. Say the anointing. From now till 31st December, you shall be anointed. If your amen is louder than your neighbor, you are taking a double dose of the anointing. From now till the end of the year, you shall be anointed. Receive the anointing over your business, over your ministry, over your career, over your children. Lift your hands up. Say, Father, anoint me with fresh oil. Listen to me, the oil is not only for pastors, the oil is for everybody. If you're an accountant, I see an anointed accountant. If you're a lawyer, I see an anointed lawyer who doesn't lose any case but wins all cases. Am I prophesying? If you're a doctor, I see an anointed doctor. If you're a singer, I see an anointed singer. I decree and declare over your life, may the oil rest upon you. May the oil come upon you. May the oil overshadow you. May the oil surround you. May the oil perambulate you. Somebody said the anointing. Come on, say loud and clear. Say the anointing. Now, very quickly, watch this. How does the anointing produce favor? Number one, when the oil comes upon you, it comes to dismantle every yoke of disfavor. and rejection and bad fortune. Anytime the anointing comes upon you, anytime the Holy Spirit overshadows you, it comes to destroy every yoke of disfavor. Somebody say, yoke of disfavor. Destroyed. It destroys every yoke of disfavor, every yoke of bad fortune, and every yoke of rejection. In Isaiah chapter 10, verse 27, and it came to pass in that day that his burden shall be taken away from off thy shoulder, and his yoke from off thy neck, and the yoke shall be destroyed because of the anointing. Listen to me. If you are here tonight and you are struggling to get a job, you are struggling for promotion, you are struggling for prosperity, you are struggling to move to your next level, may the seal of disfavor on your life be broken. Shout a big amen. May the seal be broken. I said, may the seal be broken. Everybody put your right hand on your head. Say, in the name of Jesus, I declare by the anointing, may the seal of disfavor, of bad fortune, of rejection be broken. Clap your hands. Come on, clap what I said. Clap your hands. It says that when the anointing comes upon you, the yoke is destroyed. Somebody said the yoke is destroyed. Let's push it. Number two, the anointing produces favor by destroying demonic covering cast that is covering our lives. Somebody said demonic covering casts. In Isaiah chapter 25 verse 7, put on the screen quickly. Isaiah chapter 25 verse 7, Isaiah 25 7. And he will destroy in this mountain the face of the covering cast over all people, and the veil that is spread over all nations. He will swallow up death in victory, and the Lord God will wipe away tears from off all faces. May that be your testimony. I said, may that be your testimony. The Bible said, and the rebuke of his people shall he take away from off all the earth. For the Lord has spoken. I love the verse 7. He said, and he will destroy in this mountain the face of the covering cast. Everybody put your right hand on your feet. Say, in the name of Jesus, any covering cast on my face, any covering cast covering my destiny, covering my marriage, covering my business, right now, because of the anointing, it is removed. May it catch fire in the name of Jesus. Listen to me. Ladies, you don't need too much makeup. You need the anointing. You don't need the eyeliner. You don't need the lipstick. You need the anointing. There are ladies who always paint their faces who are still not married. And there are ladies who don't paint their faces, but they don't struggle. Am I communicating? Tonight, what I'm presenting unto you is that you don't need connection. You don't need contact. You don't need any whoever. You need to be anointed. When the oil is on you, you won't struggle to marry. You won't struggle to conceive, to have babies. You won't struggle for open doors. You won't struggle to own a house. You won't struggle to drive your own car. I wish I had a witness in the house. Let me hear your loudmost amen. May the oil rest upon you. May the oil come upon you. May the anointing come upon you. Somebody say the anointing. Tap a brother or sister. Say, brother, stay anointed. Say, sister, stay anointed. Tap a brother. Say, brother, connect to the oil. Say, connect to the oil. Say, connect to the oil. So what you need is the anointing. Somebody say the anointing. Come on, say it. Or say the anointing. When the anointing is on you, whether it's Trump or it's Harris, you don't mind, because the oil will take you to where God has destined for you. Between now and 31st December, somebody will be anointed. Somebody who has been waiting for his green card or his citizenship, the anointing will release your green card unto you. The anointing will release your citizenship unto you. I wish I had a witness. I prophesy over your life. Whatever has delayed, may the anointing release it. Whatever has delayed, may the anointing bring it to you. Whatever has delayed, may the anointing put it in your hands, put it in your life. Lift up your right hand. Say, I receive the oil. Say, I receive the oil. Tap a brother. Say, hey, hey, hey. You need the anointing. And say, hey, hey, hey. You need to be anointed. And I see the Holy Ghost coming on you right now. Say a big amen. Number three, write it down. The anointing produces favor by facilitating motion. Somebody say facilitating motion. Bringing you out of obscurity into limelight. When the anointing comes upon you, your life is accelerated. Your business is accelerated. You experience motion. Somebody say motion. I want to prophesy. Let me hear your loudest amen. Don't tap a brother. Say, don't sleep on the prophet. Say, after a high praise, you don't need to sleep on the prophet, because the oil is coming on you. Can I prophesy? Stagnation is over. Retrogression is over. Setback is over. Delay is over. The anointing is coming upon you. The anointing is resting upon your life, resting upon your family, resting upon your business. I prophesy, whatever has become a limitation, whatever has become an obstacle, may the anointing clear it off. May the anointing clear it off. And I prophesy. Listen to me. The Lord said, before this year is over, you will own another house. You will own a case of land. Somebody is about to drive a new car because of the anointing. You don't need to sleep with somebody's husband for favor. You don't need to sleep with somebody's wife for favor. You don't need any connection. You just need to do the things that will connect you with the oil. And once the oil is on you, there is an automatic favor. Can I prophesy? Whatever you lack, receive it by the anointing. Whatever has delayed in your life, receive it by the anointing. Receive beauty for ashes, oil of joy for mourning, the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness. Everybody jump up on your feet and shout, I am anointed. I said, jump and shout, I am anointed. I said, jump and shout, I am anointed. Grab the hand of a brother and take your seat. Tell him or her, stay anointed. Come on, say the word. Tell him, stay anointed. Somebody say acceleration. Somebody say speed. Number four, the anointing produces favor by supernatural announcement and advertisement. Somebody say supernatural announcement. Somebody say advertisement. When the oil is on you, the oil announces you. When the oil is on you, the oil advertises you. When the oil is on you, you don't advertise yourself. When the oil is on you, you don't even need any serious brand. Once the oil is on you, the oil begins to market you. Look at our musicians like Sinatra. The anointing advertises them. Nathaniel Bassey, the anointing advertises him. Dunsin, the anointing advertises him. Look at my wonderful sister sitting here. The anointing brought them here. The anointing made the way for them where there seems to be no way. I believe they didn't even call pastor. I believe nobody even called them. Pastor heard of them. Can I prophesy? After tonight, people will hear of you. Let me hear a big amen. People will hear of you. They will hear of your business. They will hear of your ministry. They will hear of your gift. They will hear of your talent. Somebody said the anointing. Somebody said the anointing. May people hear of this church. I prophesy, by the end of 2025, this church will quadruple. I see people coming from the north, from the south, from the east, from the west to fellowship in this house because of the anointing. Somebody said the anointing. Somebody said the anointing. Be seated. I have prophet friends that go to preach in places that they don't invite them again. Our pastor friends that go to preach in places that they don't invite them again. They lack the oil. When you lack the oil, they won't call you again. I've known Pastor Ojo for over 15 years. I've been preaching for him for a long time. And I don't call him. I was in New York when he called me somewhere around June, July. He said, man of God, are you free in October? I want you to come over. Watch this. It's not because I'm a handsome pastor. It's because I'm anointed. Somebody said the anointing. Listen, if you are not smiling, you are a victim. If you are not excited, you lack the oil. You are a suspect. Can I prophesy? I decree and declare, from now till the end of the year, receive the oil. Receive the anointing. Receive the oil. Receive the anointing. May the oil come upon your ministry. Come upon your marriage. Come upon your family. Come upon your children. Somebody lift both of your hands high above your head and shout, Father, anoint me with the Holy Ghost and with power. Clap your hands together for Jesus. I'm about to wrap up. Let me give you two more points and I'm done. Write it down. The anointing produces favor. Somebody say favor. By producing supernatural magnetic attraction of both people and resources. When the anointing comes upon you, you become like a magnet, and you attract people and you attract resources. I want to say something. By the end of this year, your closing balance will not be less than $1 million. If your amen is the loudest, the anointing is pulling the money. Your closing balance will not be less than $1 million. Receive the anointing right now in the name of Jesus. When you are anointed, you magnetize men of timber and of caliber, and you magnetize resources. Somebody say resources. Somebody will drive a new car before this year is over. You will leave, you will move into your dream house before this year is over because of the anointing. Say a big amen. Now, number six, the anointing produces favor by the release of supernatural aroma and fragrance. Somebody say supernatural aroma. Somebody say fragrance. In other words, wherever you get to, people smell, when they smell the oil, favor comes. When they smell the glory, favor comes. I see the oil coming upon you, and your smell will change. After today, you will not smell disappointment. You will smell favor. Let me hear the loudest say, you will smell favor. You will smell victory. You will smell glory because of the anointing. Somebody said the anointing. When the oil comes upon you, the oil releases supernatural aroma and fragrance. Say a big amen. Now, let me move to this question and we are done. Watch this. What are the secrets to the anointing? How do you connect to the anointing? Ask your neighbor, how do you connect to the anointing? Number one, the willingness to be on the move for God. Somebody said the willingness to be on the move for God. Anytime you're on the move for God, oil comes upon you. You stay anointed. You don't struggle for the anointing. The willingness to be on the move for God, the willingness to do something for the kingdom is key to the anointing. Watch this. Going to church is not serving God. Serving God is using your gifts, your talent to advance his kingdom. If you are a member of this house and you always come here, you are doing nothing, you can't be anointed. You must discover a department and belong to the department and serve in that department. Once you are serving in the house of God, automatic, the oil will come upon you. Tap a brother, ask him, say, brother, what do you do in this church? Rise to your feet, ask about three people. What do you do in this house? What do you do in your church? What do you do in your ministry? Hallelujah. Until you are on the move. Somebody say on the move for God. Until you're on the move for God, you can't be anointed. Listen, don't just come here and warm the seat. Don't just come here as a church goer. Make sure you do something in the house of God. Join the protocol team, join the ushers, join the instrumentalists, join the choir. Do something in the house of God. And watch this. Also, what you have to do is that you have to be on the mission for soul winning and evangelism. Somebody say soul winning and evangelism. The whole of this year, I've been on a mission for God. Since the beginning of the year, I've traveled to about 6 nations, all preaching the gospel. Went to Madagascar to preach, went to South Africa to preach, went to Bahamas to preach. I've been in America. This is my second time of coming here. I'm just on the move for God. Once you are on the move for God, you will stay anointed and remain anointed. Can I prophesy? After today, the oil is coming upon you to move you from where you are to do something for God, to do something for His kingdom. Hold the hand of a brother and look at his face. Say, hello, brother. Go somewhere. Preach somewhere. Say, hey, hey, hey. Go somewhere. Sing somewhere. Preach somewhere. Minister somewhere. Say, hey, hey, hey. Go somewhere. Say, move from your house. Say, move from your house. There are people who have stayed in Milwaukee, Wisconsin for over 30 years and have never moved to any state of America before. How can you stay anointed? How can you remain anointed? Hold the hand of a brother. Say, brother, go somewhere. Preach somewhere. Teach somewhere. Prophesy somewhere. Minister somewhere. Evangelize somewhere. Travel somewhere. Can I prophesy? Receive the anointing. Receive the anointing. Receive the anointing. Receive the anointing. Hallelujah. Listen. You don't need a new shoe. You need the anointing. You don't need a new shirt. You need the anointing. You don't need a new tie. You need the anointing. Receive the oil right now. In the name of Jesus. Somebody say, I receive it. Watch this quickly. Number two. Be willing to make a difference in your life. The willingness to make a difference on the lives of others is key to the anointing. Somebody said the willingness. Don't be selfish. Don't just think of your husband, yourself, your wife, your children. Think of others. Think of ministering to others. Being a blessing to others. The willingness to make a difference on the lives of others is key to the anointing. Number three, hatred for both the oppressed and the oppressor. Somebody say hatred for both the oppressed and the oppressor. It will connect you to the oil. Number four, addiction to his presence. Say addiction to his presence. Hunger for God. Be desperate for God. Step into prayer and fasting. Live a holy life. Live a righteous life. Hunger for God. Thirst for God. Desperation for God is key to the anointing. Now let me run through the steps quickly. Then we'll rise to pray. Number one, the willingness to be on the move for God. Number two, the willingness to make a difference on the lives of others. Number three, hatred for both the oppressed and the oppressor. And number four, addiction to his presence. Somebody say addiction to his presence. Hold the hand of a brother. Say, brother, whatever you have to do to remain anointed, to stay anointed, receive it.